My name is Marcus Bulstrode and I work for the Queensland Department of Agriculture and Fisheries. I'm working with growers to better understand their farm, taking it from managing the farm as a big single unit to reducing it down and managing it as separate small management units. This could be an area of just a few square metres, or it might be an area of a few hundred metres. It's a very exciting time to be in agriculture. New technologies such as drones are providing a whole range of new tools for us to be able to better manage farms. What we actually do with the drone, it's basically taking high resolution images of the crop. And it's the crop that actually shows us the difference in the growing conditions. And that's a very important aspect of it. Yep, that's very poor cane through here. There's all sorts of weeds that have dried off. That's the area that I want to be able to go back into that paddock and see what's going on. Take a marker. That marker is now a geo-referenced point that I can go back to with another device, such as an iPad. I can walk back into this paddock and stand at that precise point and start to do some analysis to work out, okay, how can I fix it? I'll be able to analyse this soil core and start to understand what the limiting conditions may be for crop growth. We start to get a colour change as we come down through the soil profile. And then when we get right down here, we've actually got, that's virtually beach sand. So not a good growing medium and something that would be needing to be treated to be able to grow cane properly. I should be able to improve this area to make the crop grow better. We're actually trialing some different techniques to improve the soil in those poor growing areas. We're going to actually add some organic matter and some clay and see whether we can increase the water holding capacity and also the nutrient holding capacity of these soils. Today we're here at the Thomason's farm doing our yield constraints identification and mitigation trial. We've done soil testing, taken cores, done all sorts of things, and we're here actually digging out the soil features that are growing the poor cane, and we're altering them around, putting in much better soil so that we'll grow better cane within these zones in the paddock. This is just one of the methods that we're using to improve a particular part of a particular farm. This is the material that we've just dug out of Lido's paddock, and we can see that it's almost pure sand. Doesn't hold moisture, doesn't hold nutrients, everything can leach out of it and grows about one third of the cane volume that the rest of the part of this farm does. I'll just show you the different soil products that we're going to be putting back into these treatments. This is the sand. So we've dug this out of the area that we're trying to fix. We're going to bring in this, which has come from a nearby quarry. Still a very sandy granite-based material, but this time it's got lots of clay in it. So we're going to introduce a certain amount of this into this mix. Here we have mill mud. Mix that in. And this one is ash from the mill, a byproduct from the mill. And we're going to put that in. All of this will be mixed together, and that's what we're putting back down as the subsoil to go underneath our cane. On top of this will be the topsoil that we left beside those holes that we dug out, and we'll pull that back in on top, about 20 centimetres of that. The cane roots can now move down through that into this layer, which will be good for holding moisture, good for holding nutrients, and it's got organic matter in it. Okay, so you might have seen before I took some soil samples. So we've taken soil samples from the subsoil that we've taken away. We've taken soil samples from the material that we're adding to the hole, and then we'll be able to see what sort of a change chemically we've made to it. So we're very lucky working on this particular property. Lido is very enthusiastic about trialing these newer ways of getting improved cane yield, and he's been particularly supportive. He's got lots of equipment to help us with the trial. It's the sort of thing that without Lido's collaboration in this case, we perhaps couldn't even do a trial like this. So this trial will run over multiple years. We're going to evaluate all of the areas that we treat, as well as leaving some areas untreated. So we'll be able to see, do we get a difference in the growth of the cane? And that will be tons of cane as well as CCS. And we're also taking soil samples to see how the soil changes in its chemical and its physical properties. And we'll do this for a number of years, so perhaps even over the full crop cycle, so maybe 5 or 6 years, and we'll see how long this sort of amelioration work can still increase or still maintain higher yields. This is a farm that we've actually done the initial trials on and assessing what volume of cane we're getting from the different treatments. Across the farm, we've got quite a bit of variability. We've got the areas that we've treated that were really poor, and then we've got here, for example, pretty much the average cane. This is a really nice crop, and this would be a good amount of cane to lift the poor areas up to, so that we have a somewhat even block to manage in the future. So what they're doing here today, they're cutting what we call seed cane. They're cutting the cane to plant another block. If this was a normal harvesting day, we would have machines roaring up and down continuously. But because it is a planting exercise, we have quite big gaps between the harvester going through and the haulouts going through. Okay, so the process here of collecting a sample is that we come up against a clean cane face. So the harvester has gone through and it's left us with a lovely clean face to be able to get in and take the cane samples from.
So I might get the 5 right on the edge of this lot.
We measure out 5 metres of cane row, and then we'll cut all of that cane out. We'll clean all of the trash off the cane sticks, bring it towards a weigh trailer, so a trailer that's got a flat bed and we can put the cane on top of it to weigh it. So what we've got here is a load cell weigher. Underneath here we've got load cells that can sense the weight of this deck and then everything that we put on top of it. So we'll just zero out the weigh deck. Now that we've got zeros, we can load all the cane and get a value for this 5 metres that we've just cut. Okay, so here we are with our weight whole stick with tops, and we've got 106.5 kilograms for 5 metres of row. That's fantastic. That's a lot of cane. The grower will be very happy with the crop that he's getting this year from both the average and the treated areas of the farm, but the poor areas that are untreated are still producing very little cane, about half the cane that we're getting here. Then we'll cut the tops out and just weigh the stick itself, which is more representative of the volume of cane that would go to the mill if the harvester was to mill it, because the harvester would be cutting the tops out. From that, we can weigh the cane and work out how many tons per hectare we're getting from our average parts of the farm, the poor parts of the farm, and in this case, the parts of the farm that we've treated the growing area to make it better. But I'll take one stick, a bit of a representative stick of what we've just cut, and I'll crush the stick, make the juice come out onto this Brix meter, it's just a digital Brix meter, and it'll give me a value to show me how much sugar is actually a percentage of sugar that's in the cane. I'm just going to bruise it a bit around here so that I can bend it without it snapping. And then when I bend the stick now, the cane juice, which is delicious by the way, that will drip out, and that's what I'm going to measure on the Brix meter. Okay, so we've now got the Brix reading from that cane. I'll be able to record that and we'll compare it against the different treatments that we've done on the farm. We've cut 6 sticks out of each of our treatments, and the Tully Mill small mill, it's a mill on the back of a ute, has come along and crushed those samples to get the juice out. And the juice will then show us what the sugar content is from those particular plots, so we can then look at what the different treatments have done. One of the very interesting things about the cane industry, the sugar cane industry, is that their payment is for sugar, not for tons of cane. The mill is very happy with tons of cane, but the grower wants sugar, tons of sugar. And so in these trials, we make sure that we're assessing the tons of sugar that is produced so that any benefit can be directly related back to the grower. If he was to do this particular type of practice change, he would be able to increase the sugar return on the work that he's done. At first, we used to think that farms were fairly even, but the drone mapping has revealed that most farms have a high level of variability. We just didn't know it before. We now have a tool where we can easily identify that variability and set about doing something about it.